In the heart of peace and power of this council today, we always make the best decisions of the county of our community and the powers as individuals and keep us safe. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to the Texas. Let the nation be the flag of the United States of America. And to the republic which stands one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, we have here a letter from the Ballinger County Library to the city of Ballinger thanking us for our efforts. I guess I could read the whole thing. On behalf of the library board, I would like to thank you for generously allowing us to have our county library fundraiser. A taste of Ballinger, the community center without charge. Serving the crowd is so much easier there. I appreciate the effort that the city workers put forth to clean up the community center after the stock show so that we didn't have this fundraiser. I also appreciate the workers who helped put up the tables and chairs. Thank you for working with us to serve this wonderful community in which we live. We appreciate all the ways that the city supports the library. Without all the help we provide, we would have a hard time making this a sincerely proud place of Ballinger Church. Okay, at this time, the council will discuss and take necessary action to move forward with the dog park after a presentation by Ms. Laura Brown.
I want to thank the council for listening to me tonight. I am ready to go ahead and start looking this again and see how I'm certain to get both city and myself combined by doing some of this here. But tonight, I want to ask some questions possibly as the group so we can begin working and finishing up the final process and then simple work day to where me and other students can finally get some stuff assembled and the dog park can be finished. This will probably take some time before May. I definitely want to be somewhere out hoping during the break studies and the race is going to be a part of their mind. But just for some of the things that we just need to have the final touches on, there are some things that go on. So I talked to Lane, she mentioned that the fencing needs to be explored. That we have from the main cup plan. Is that true? Because the first thing we're going to put in the storage committee from the public and look at. If it does, if yes, good. If not, we'll have to figure out a way to hold the doors and the fencing, but I'm too sure that the storage committee is going to get rid of it still functioning. As for our dog park side, we talked with Corey about some rules approved by the city. About what exactly we have to set colored lines for people visiting dog parks, such as those small children under the age of 6, bringing their own dogs to home with them, dogs that have been vaccinated, et cetera, and sent the signs to Ryan if you all about the locality. And possibly I talked a little past the end. If you go from the elementary school, there's a little bit of a tire jungle. It's easy to set up. You might have to play a concrete with that too, just from the middle of it. I talked to Gordon, she mentioned that Paskey does have a lot of work with the tires that we can get from the tire. And so, at those two dog parks, we're a little bit of a prototype for anybody else to visit. And finally, there would be possibility of this girl to pass on to me with my advice to help get this project. Was the possibility of dysfunctional firefighters that the city can no longer utilize for their original purpose, that would be put the dog park for decoration. So just those four things, fencing, sign, the entire park, just those need to be approved and start getting more objects and charges of nation. As far as I know, the consent of the board, I have the delivery of stones, torches, and benches, the tables, the waste bins, just normal metal heat that would be outside of just parts of recreation inside of the actual dog park. So if the city has any questions for
Thank you.
senior year. Well, thank you, and I will keep in touch with my husband to fix an excellent one that before. I need the initial check, please get us all the minutes to get through this. Okay. So at this time, we'll hear updates from the mayor and city council members on activities of community interest.
So I just want some clarification because the excavator was originally listed as a primary reason that the previous city manager was let go, and that you're totally specifically meaning that the mayor and the new city manager had worked with Yellow House and that they were not going to repossess that and they were going to buy it back, and then they would just casually mention the meeting following that that we're keeping the excavator. So I would like to know more details as to why if we were told that it was being sent back and it all worked out, it wasn't sent back.
Can't
respond to anything. You can actually respond. It's your choice. You can respond, you can't vote on it. looking for.
Okay, we're gonna put this on the agenda and we don't have a response for you at the next week conference.
I want to comment on one of these texts, how I should, in the city comment. Last week, I believe that every chamber of commerce citizen is gonna get a trillion of council members to that board. I congratulate the public, that being said, and I think that's a good honor, and I think you guys need some congratulations. It speaks a lot of council that you represent, by the chamber.
Yes.
Okay, my next question is, isn't the city manager supposed to have a physical address if he's employed by the city? Is that not a city property?
It's a city manager.
I thought it was a charter that the city manager, if he was employed by the city, had to have a physical address within the city, not on city property. Okay, my next question is, how many council members were included in and present on the voting of the recommended firing of Eric Smith?
No voting was necessary.
Okay, was any of the main reason for being fired? Is that not a policy procedure that you are to be given a reason when you are terminated?
No.
According to employment, Texas Employment Commission or city council regulations?
According to, including law, I mean, state law, no, state law, it's important to the state.
For those of you who know me, I'm Sarah Gonzalez, I'm a lifetime citizen of Reynolds County. I've lived in my residence for 38 years, and I'm here about 4 or 5 Wall Street. I'm on January 25th, 2020, I'm going to lunch, and I think this was discussed back in April, 2018. I was treated barricaded, and it's about, so I go to lunch, I see that it's barricaded again, so I call the city hall and ask for the city manager. And I was told that you probably have some lunch provisions, I told the shop and I called. I left my name and number, so about 2 minutes before, he called me back, I'm at work, and we had a conversation, and I asked him about the room being blocked off of him. And I say to him that this has already been before the city council about it being blocked, and about a year and a half ago. And so as soon as I tell him that, the tone changes. And this is what I was told, and as God is my witness, I am not here to lie, and I am not here to call any problems. Okay? This is what I was told. I was told, I don't care who you are in that tone. I don't care what has been before the city council. I don't care what has been before the city council. I don't care who I am, the city manager, and I will do what I need to do. This is a city property, and I do what I want. The dirt is being stolen. I respond to it. As long as I can, because I hear this tone of voice, and I don't, I'm responding with, I totally understand protecting city investment. I am also protecting my investment. And I believe that I can pay street taxes, and yes, I am grateful to the city for the new street that you got. It was our trust, and now they're 2 parts of the new. And also for the street sign, for North Park Wall Street, also for the signs. I'm grateful for that, okay? But to me, those were very piercing, hurtful, disrespectful tone, and I chose not to raise my voice back at the city manager or to use my Jesus at that time. To the way I was talked to, and it was, to me, I don't know about y'all, but to me, it was very unprofessional. It was very disrespectful to me. And the way it was conducted. I was in a awe because I didn't want to say it to that because I was like, I'm going to do it, you know? So I was in awe and that I didn't understand.
spend, what I set it off to use that towing speed and to tell me those things. Those three, when I caught those three out here, I was like, okay, come on, I'll sit off. My answer is a lot. I answer Kawaki.
We got this 3 minutes.
Yes, I know. That's why I'm talking fast. I asked Kawaki to put me on the next agenda, and I was told, how do you put me on the agenda? Put yourself on the agenda. I said, okay, sir. God bless you. Bye. And I called Lolita, and she took my name and my number, and then I called back the next day to see what agenda was going to be on. This second agenda was following me. And I was told by Lolita, I was told that you need to speak to my name. I said, okay, she gave me the name and number. Me and you sat a meeting. I don't know what the meeting said. He called me back on the work on the phone, and we met. My husband and I met in line, the councilman of Houston 3. We discussed and filled in enough concerns about Wall Street and had a conversation about the city manager. This is what I was told by Ryan. Correct me if I'm wrong. I was told, he's an enemy. This is how enemies talk. That's what I was told. Am I correct, Brian? Okay. Indeed, so if we looked, we talked the one down the street, we walked around and so forth, we looked at the minutes. He said, look at the minutes. When it happened, when whatever it was. I looked at the minutes, I texted to him the next day, April 2nd, and I sent it to Ryan on the text, because I was going out of town, so I kept calling it. So I said, okay. So then the following day, didn't happen the weekend. Then March the 7th, which was this morning, Ryan called me and I asked him about 4th Street, we talked about other streets around the house and stuff. And his response is, they told me to change the plan. And the reason I wrote all this was because I didn't want to miss dates or whatever. Ryan says that he was able to tell me he didn't have time to review minutes. He tells me, he broke around. If he sees no problem, I explained to him about the other street concerns that I had, and he said, this is what I was told. He said,
stop.
Because I was telling him about the two streets,
I
know this is
not
the best time.
Okay, I'm going to stop. Because I guess to be respectful to everyone else, how about if we set a meeting or put you on the agenda for the next time? The next city council meeting, rather than do it during this portion of the meeting, I would say,
it's a meeting.
Okay.
And for a fact, that he had to meet with his office. He said, I know what you're doing. He said, I told the former city department to talk. And we'll deal with it when it comes up.
So can we put you on the agenda for the next city council
meeting? He said,
Or maybe schedule a meeting with our at a later time. Okay.
Can I just say one more point?
Yes.
But I put those words and that tone under the blood of Jesus. I forgive you. And I ask in Jesus' name that this, because you don't want to go back to what all the chaos. I can teach you. So thank you.
Thank you.
Judges are in control of the county auditor, but not his staff. in that space. So they would be in the county auditor, the space that we need. So the district judge, who's the fourth clerk, the district judge is coming.
Do you want to answer Josh and Chase's actual?
Sure.
Office?
Yes, ma'am, I do. Maybe if you go in, I took a washing machine from Austin, outside of Austin, to this person's house because she couldn't wash her clothes. She had no way of washing her clothes, and we didn't make fun of. And I did not pay for it, but it was transformed to washing machine. That was one of the articles that they said. She was leaving by arm one to go to a towing company. And as her exiting room, she said this thing. We went through an arbitration that lasted 8 hours, and all during the 8 hours, the arbitrator was a very tough one, all the way through the car and everything else, all the way through. So about 2 o'clock, she comes in, she slumps down in the chair, and she says, "There's exclusions." And I said, "I told you that at 8 o'clock in the morning." One of them got 5,000. She was working with me. This is how crazy this person is. She was an Eastern Star, and she thought because the district judges were amazing that they would hire her. She had never worked anywhere in any kind of high level job. I was a CPA at the time with almost 30 years of experience. So they got together, I said to me, "God, you need to pick me out. You know, when you get my job." But all I do is help those people. I train one of them for 3 years. I train that just the one that's sitting at about 25,000. She only started working for me, by the way, like 2 months earlier. So
what you're saying is that the people in these cultures started in black and white was all lies.
That's not right. I didn't want to respond, and I'm responding now, and I really shouldn't.
Well,
I'm not supposed to even say anything about this, but I want to give them those. This is what happened. I helped these people. The county auditor there now is just me. She's been there 10 years. I trained her across the table for 4 years. We call her Sister Mary. You ask me, I'm responding. What I'm saying is, I help these people. I train them. I do everything they want. And then they turn around and speak.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, I can still some time left. I just want to say, this is all very hurtful on the citizens. You're supported. You're voters. You have. And council members have turned your back on us. We've all come in here for a public meeting. The door is locked. We're going to be escorted out by the police if we say the wrong thing. Why are y'all doing this to the citizens? We are your financial backbone.
Thank you.
How many of us think that you're going to be escorted out if you say the wrong thing?
You will get the money behind the meeting for something. If it's not unworthy, okay?
If it's disrespectful and unworthy.
And disrespectful,
yes. Disrespectful.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. And that should be accepted by everyone because that's the way it should be done.
So what is yours?
I would like to say that a lot of women in this room wanted Tommy Turner removed because he said the F word. And you're blaming a man that's had lawsuits for sexual harassment. That doesn't make a bit of sense to me.
You're assuming you're guilty. And I was.
Well, they were paid.
So you're guilty. Yeah.
I have a skin in this game. And I don't know you from now, so I don't really care to. But, what'd you say?
He said good.
they have people just like you, said Phil, her answer. You don't call people grits.
Anybody else?
But a little bit on as well. The reason everybody is upset, not only must be for everybody, but it's maybe sometimes the way you present yourself or speak to certain people or dismissively say good. Maybe you can stop for a second before you do that and we won't be so upset. For me, the water extension thing, no extension across the board, I'll make it work. I gotta have water. There are a lot of people in this town who need help. And I understand also that there's a lot of people in this town who probably could use that as well. But at a time when we are asked to bear with the changes that are going on, the new staff learning everything, the problems that have happened, and work with it and work with you, and then the very next month, no exceptions, high library, big bully. Now, I don't know if that was a unilateral decision or if that was a council decision. I don't see how it could be if there was no meeting in between. However, that's the issue that I have with it, that I have with it, is that I feel that it should have been discussed here because it affects the city as a whole in a very large way. I'm not going to say that I've never asked for an extension in my life. I've been there. I've gone through some times. And I understand some people do too. But to just say, no. And then to also say that we don't respond on Facebook, we don't read Facebook, we don't do anything, you can't do that and then have a Facebook page to put out notices on. People are commenting you can't be here, and I know that you can see it, and I know that you're aware of it. So please, don't just disregard that. Because even if we can't stand here, it's like I had a baby here tonight to stand here and say this. We are watching, we care, and we have problems. I do want to say thank you. I don't know if it was the council or something, but people who live on 13th have noticed that they have painted down some metal panels and put us in chain link to where you can see through it. Because I was a little disheartened at first to see that it wasn't on this agenda when I brought it up last time and wasn't brought up before. I appreciate that if that was the council. I don't know. I just happened to know the tree going up 13th Street today. But you know, that really should have been taken care of a long time ago. And moving the yield sign was just a minute. I really think that's it. It's just choose your words a little better. And we are not just some big city. We are a small community who knows pretty much everybody. Everybody knows each other. Everybody cares. Everybody's willing to help out and do whatever. So just think a little bit more before you speak and how you speak. And I think they will feel a lot better.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. Do you think? You want to answer? I'm with her on that bill. I was quite upset when I saw the yellow flashing. And I'm thinking the people who might be on vacation are elderly and going to get down to pay their bill and with no extension and all. That's not fair, just to put it out there. You know, I know that none of you are judges. None of you are judges. I've talked to judges and I've talked to the Texas Municipal League. The only power that you guys have is while you're sitting in this chair to make a decision. But lately, it's been brought to my attention by citizens of this community that our mayor and Christy have been taking upon themselves to take power and making decisions and leaving council members out, other council members out, and it's not being brought to council. The decisions that are being made that should be at this meeting.
That'd be incorrect.
No.
No, man. No problem, I agree. And I don't appreciate it either that no severance pay because it was so sudden, because he was told, no, you're going to have a job, and I'm speaking about Tommy, that you're going to have a job, and then he's let go that night with no severance pay. Paying vacation and sick leave is not severance pay. Because usually if you don't give a person 2 weeks notice, severance pay is given. And that is not fair. And I understand that if the severance pay wasn't given to Brian, but he already spent over $60,000 on himself and other council members at the time. So he got his care of severance pay that way. Yeah, and he was, it was in his contract to pay the rest of his salary. So I just have some complaints, and I've been out due to help, but I'm back, and I'm listening, and I'm watching, and I'm here to complain to our city citizen community.
Are you ready?
Sure.
Because I want to ask Joyce, how to work better, I'm doing here, and to talk about public perception. You know, we've got a bunch of stuff going on, and you're not really vocal about it.
Yeah.
You're not telling us what we need to know as the public. I'm going to go through my list now. We've got two elected officials. Two of them are on here, and we agreed to give CHL classes to city employees. Mm-hmm. If you were here, I was here at the meeting.
Talking to y'all a lot. But we
said, like, we don't work 24/7, and nothing is made publicly to help alleviate that, that hurts y'all.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that hurts y'all bad, you know, as a mother. I mean, because the protect and serve thing is what everybody's expecting. Like, they don't expect to be told them, we don't work 24/7.
Mm-hmm.
And the perception when you demote somebody and then fire them 2 days later because city manager can't fire a supervisor, that's a bad perception.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, she's a
that
y'all put it on the meeting specifically at 2 minutes that say that the city manager could not remove a department head on his own without going to the council. Y'all specifically voted in the side.
Yeah, it's not your speaking time, and I believe you that he's still standing and he still has the floor.
I can see the chair.
Okay.
Y'all specifically voted as a council and decided that the city manager did not have the right to remove the department head without an official vote from the city council.
And it's
in the minutes.
manual at the top. No, he will shut off his back.
An excellent employee.
Yes. He's a hard worker. He was my neighbor for several years. Now, that is all I have to say about Barry. I know that my opinion on him has no effect on y'all, but he is a good man, and I love that on my record because he is. And he did not deserve to be recommended twice for one offense.
Okay, we're moving on. Okay. Do we have a motion to accept it? Who's that? That's that girl?
What's the motion?
Okay, no other questions? Do we have a second?
I'll second.
Okay, all in favor? Okay.
Does that include the building permits that goes in there?
Yes.
Okay.
Just check. Okay, consider, council will consider and take action regarding use of firearms at the city lake.
I'm on this one.
Uh-huh.
Per past administrations, there have been some issues with people being allowed to shoot at the lake. Because it's public property, and I'm not saying that can't happen. This is an apartment, this is a city. So I just need to make it clear for the public notice that you will not be allowed to shoot firecrackers here. You know, there's people out there firecrackers, that's the main thing. And so we had a couple of people go out there this year, and they said it was all right, because someone's always had a little bit. And so we just need to make it clear that it's city property, on my team, within the city limits. And it's not just like a bar, in the city limits. Unless it's far, unless it's far out of the range, because I'm shooting.
So it's already a law, it's not like.
Right, just to go ahead and go, someone goes out there and open with firecrackers and.
So you need to make people aware that that is.
And I've always, you know, followed the order to make sure that we made that this is on the job, so you, this is, city property, and make sure you have.
It says not discharge.
Yeah, discharge.
Saying, originally talked about, I'm all set there, you're allowed.
Then, and that was another, we had, I know we had some models out there, and I'm not, I don't know if they're still out there or not yet. But, I mean, yeah, they don't really come to go. And all of our parents are kind of, they're forming thing now, when it's on all of those. They need to use firearms, they need dogs and knives. So, they allowed that to keep the hogs off the, property, because it's, I mean, because it's like a war, so to speak. So, but they're, hogs are anyway. So, that was allowed, and one was not. And so, you know, we're talking that, they could have said, if you have a hog problem, you know, that we're.
Okay.
So, I said, well, yeah, some people were out there sleeping, but they were using firearms, they're catching them off things, because they were out there, they don't have them. So, we didn't ask them, you know, what you're allowing for that, or, you know, that's that kind of thing, or they didn't have to discuss.
Do we have any rules to adopt?
The only thing that I've seen, and I checked it 6 months ago, before, it was against, discharging dangerous weapon. It's not saying, so I didn't say beat and kill, but that's considered dangerous, it's pretty, big as far as the way it goes, but a knife wouldn't be discharging it, a weapon.
But probably, like a knife, though.
It's,
you know, getting that thing.
Yeah, with gray or that. It's great, it's not the same thing.
Is it not confusing that the lake is city property, but it's confusing that it is not actually in the city limits?
Right.
I think this is where the problem is.
Okay.
And then, what if you're out there picnicking and stuff, but you have your gun and your vehicle and stuff, but you've got a snake or something that comes up and you go after your kids?
That's.
You know, that's basically.
That's
not.
But, I mean, you're not going out there intentionally going to shoot your gun. Yeah.
It's not like you're an officer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're arresting them out front.
So, I mean, if you're going out there and you're on the way, you're running around and something comes up, you're trying to, shoot it and get rid of it, that's it, so. But then this is what I'm talking about is people running the old way, and back and forth, and just doing it as firecrackers.
So the action would be taken.
include signage?
I'm just designing to make sure that no one, I mean, it's, if, I don't think you can, you know, allow fog in San Antonio, as long as one of those, I would say. But that way, just across the board, and now if you get a paint problem or something, and have a special permit or something, I don't know. So, but now it's getting longer, people don't come up, and the siding stuff, they got the Christmas and all that good stuff, so, that's our problem.
I want to stay in that, put on some movies, and why, because of the time.
Okay.
Proper diamonds for it, that you're, I mean,
going with that. You're just now trying to put this in place, obviously, because of the incident that happened.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, so I mean, okay, we can go back in time and change what previous administration did or anything of those natures. All we can do is move forward, okay? And when things are brought to the city council's attention, and I'm speaking on behalf of several guys because I'm speaking wrong, speak up, but as things are brought to their attention, they must deal with it in the best way they know and see. Okay, so we can't go back and change any of that stuff, okay? We have what we have right here and right now.
That is your
friend who's threatening him.
Charter, and it has to be voted on by the general public to be
was it as true?
It was a building where he not even worked in the computer center.
So you probably.
He doesn't have a gallon, Paul Penn wasn't even there.
I didn't hear it.
What? He was the one who did it, he wasn't even there.
I think it's him.
The video of all. It doesn't matter because it's your body.
So I'm not repeating. that's investigation.
So, it was suicide, she didn't think she'd be there.
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm running.
Okay, sure, I got a lot of patients. I think it's a bad idea across the board, but the reason I think it's a bad idea is because I'm agreeing with Chad, that if there is a situation where an employee would be safer having his weapon, because we know that we are shorthanded as far as officers, even though we're trying to remedy that, and how quick that they can get there in case something is happening. So, I mean, I get what has happened has caused this discussion, and I appreciate that. And if the city feels, city council feels that they want to put certain proper signage on specific buildings because it would make you feel better, okay. But please, girls, please, do not take away your employees' rights to carry that lawfully after they have gone through the process of registering that. That's all of my.
Okay. Did you want to go ahead and speak your piece?
Yeah, if I allow.
Yes, ma'am, all right.
Well, the thing is, churches are in the middle because of so many shootings, and they had to be prepared. I know our church and so many other people in downtown have got safety teams, and they've got security there. They had to because of so many shootings of being done in churches and schools. I went to a shooting in Columbine, and it's not fun. And if we have people who have guns, so many kids wouldn't have been killed. And let me tell you, that is what I don't want to live through again. And don't like the folks out. Anybody who carries a gun, it's not going to just pull it out for no reason. But be prepared and watch around you. Be aware of your surroundings. That's what you have to be. You can't have tunnel vision. You go to the post
and
office, and you go to the post office, and then folks just say you don't carry a gun in there.
Okay,
thank you.
Yes, ma'am. This is a second. We gotta move on.
I need to start. Like me.
car storage.
See,
that
I saw
that.
That's not in my house.
Yes, heaters and.
Refrigerator.
Yes, refrigerator, things like that.
And we're looking for shelves to start.
Yeah, we're looking for shelves.
Right, let's say average.
We lost $30 a month in the past 3 months, which I guess we kind of needed a lot of $80.
Oh, that's just crazy.
I don't know if it's the one that we think of maybe like what we call down on the street for the roads and building homes.
That's sick.
On there. Council will take action on bids for stem pipe water tank. Considering take action on this issue.
And four bids. Really hard from. Folks that were down from the north, South Dakota, to Minnesota's, north from Kirkville. One that did 106 was from South Dakota, and that's the recommended bid that they engineers recommend. It's entitled that they inside the water tower, and has been getting worse. Set up in the hall, and there's a broken part at the top. The five panels originally that needed to be replaced, and it turns out really only three of them too. So everybody's on the same page from the bid, and the bid range from 206 to 338,800. And the engineers recommending 206, 300. The wire iron out of South Dakota and so on. They understand what they're supposed to do. They looked at the cost and we looked at the debt qualifications and they pass it. And that will be under the amount that we have to do. So those are
Or maybe, sorry.
What did you say?
We just called them probably the last week. serious.
I did it all wrong.
So, I'm going to go to the club. So, it's a Saturday community. Okay, this is what I'm going to do.
So, you want to go to the club? I was going to go to the club tonight.
Yeah, I'm going to do that.
The weekend of four days needs to fill up with maybe just one night. Single night, I really.
Yeah, I'm going to do that.
I'm going to make that, is that too? There's nothing on that weekend with us, as far as like.
Being patient, waiting outside to the poll for us. How's that going?
It's all good. It's all good.
Good. Okay. Okay, so we're out of the executive session, and so we need to take action on the permanent placement of Mike New as street superintendent.
I'll make a motion that we hire Mike as an interim street superintendent and then go out for applications through the paper or and see if we can find anybody to come in to examine more people, give them opportunities.
While also considering, you know, he can apply as well.
He can apply.
As the promise, yeah.
I like that.
Do I have a second?
I'll second that.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Okay, we've done that. Do we need to discuss future city agenda items at this time to go on? What? It's not on here, but who brought it up? We should have that stuff. It should be on there.
We need to talk about the gun again. We need to, I guess, do we need to do anything with Laura Brown as far as checking on the fencing stuff? Does that need to be on the agenda, or we just need to do it?
We just need to confirm that the fencing is still in storage for her.
And then get her access to it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't think that's an agenda item.
We do need to approve the signage. We talked about stop signs on 11.
Kind of signage of the city? Oh, that was tabled until Stan and... Stella is either going to be added to the agenda or have a meeting. She's not or set a meeting, so I think probably a meeting is probably first on the agenda, so that probably needs to be set up at some point between Buck and Stella. Okay, anything else? Anything else? Okay. We're going to be a united council. We're moving forward with positivity. We appreciate you guys joining us in that effort. I believe at this time, do we have a motion to adjourn?
I make a motion to adjourn.
Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.